Hi there guys, this is Michael Vincent and welcome to another session in the Vincent Academy Magic Moments. Today I'd like to say a special thank you to my friend Michael Kulik from Poland. Mike and I were having a conversation and I asked him specifically, what would you like me to talk about in the next video session? And without missing a beat, he said, can you talk a little bit about the history of magic and the origin of things and what we as magicians can do to further our knowledge about where all of these great mysteries came from? And as soon as he said that, I thought, you know what, this is a great conversation, simply because I don't consider myself to be the most original magician. No, I've developed a very beautiful relationship with the subject, and that has come specifically from reading old books. I have a very big library, and I have some very old books, first editions. As a matter of fact, one of my favorite books of all time is the masterpiece, The Secrets of Conjuring and Magic by Robert Houdin. This is the most glorious book on the subject. And I was looking through the section on card magic recently, and it occurred to me all of the tricks that we see performed today are in this book, albeit in a rather simple form. In fact, the variations that we see performed today, guess what? Overly convoluted, too much procedure, and as a result, the magic suffers. I want to pay tribute to a magician who really inspired me, and that was Mike O'Brien. Now, Mike O'Brien is a member of the Magic Circle. When I was a young boy, I overheard Mike in conversation with another magician. This magician had asked Mike a question. He said, hey Mike, how did you put your egg bag routine together? And Mike responded by saying, when I want to learn a specific trick, I will research everything I can get on that specific routine. Not just research, but I will study and practice everything I can get my hands on, and then I'll forget about it. I'll leave it alone for a while. And then somewhere out of the blue, my own ideas will come together and I will create something that's mine. I heard this when I was about 18. And I have to tell you, that advice has been working away in the back of my mind without me being aware of it. The Travelers, Triumph, The Lady's Looking Glass, John Ramsay's Coins and Cylinder, Card in Box, Card to Pocket, most of the routines from Stars of Magic. Guess what? I have studied so many different versions of all of these classic routines, and today I'm at 54 years of age, middle-aged. Guess what? I now have routines that I'm very proud of. Dr. Sauer's slot machine. This is a routine where I studied about 3 or 4, maybe 5 different versions until I came up with a routine that I'm very proud of. Cups and balls. I treated cups and balls as a concept. I studied different routines, not just Vernon. I often hear people say the Di Vernon routine is the archetypal model for every magician. You know what? To me, that's nonsense. Don't get me wrong. The Vernon routine is beautiful. I have a lot of things to say about that routine, but I'm going to say one thing. I don't think it's the greatest routine in the cups and balls. No way. I've seen the greatest routine in the cups and balls. I'm not going to tell you which one it is. That's not important. I do think the Vernon routine has a lot of merit, but I don't think it's the be-all and end-all of the subject. No way. Not when we have so many different ideas and concepts that we can apply to a given routine. Why should we be stuck in one mode of thinking? Why? Because Vernon was a great master. Yes, he was. But his conversation didn't start and end with cups and balls. No. There are other great magicians who added some very significant elements to this conversation. So here's the point. Take a routine in your repertoire and be willing to start again. I don't care what the routine is. Ambitious card, cups and balls, doesn't matter. And then start again, go back to basics, go through your library and find everything you can on this given subject. Read, study, practice, think. Now, here's the magic question. If you had the power, what would it look like if you really had the power and it happened as if by magic? In the Books of Wonder, Tommy talks about the mind movie, Tommy Wonder. Imagine you could do it and you had a real magician. Forget about the method. Just go through the motions. I did this with Vernon's Travelers. I put four aces in four different pockets while wearing a jacket. I stood in front of my mirror and I noticed one thing immediately. I wasn't holding the deck. And yet still my hands were empty and I reached into each pocket and removed each of the four aces. When I saw that picture for myself, I was immediately struck by one simple thought. Wow, if I could stand in front of an audience with my hands completely empty and remove four aces from four different pockets, that would be a beautiful thing, an elegant solution. I was about 15 at the time. It took me half my life to solve it. And I did. And I've come up with a masterpiece. I'm sharing this today to inspire you. Just because you've learnt a routine in the book, do not for 1 minute consider it the last word on that specific routine. If you like the routine enough, do the research. Go back in time. Chances are you'll find a version of it in the old books. And when I say old, I'm talking books published before 1900. Oh yes, Hofsenzer, Rabia Houdin, many others. If you can get your hands on these old books, guess what? You just might be in for a beautiful surprise. Leave your comments below. Let me know what you think about this video, because I believe there's a lot of merit in what I shared with you today, simply because anything that I share with you, guess what, guys? I've applied it to my own magic. Stay tuned for another magic moment. Thanks for listening. Bye for now.